after pursuing this profit, he should sustain permanently and also carrying out a social mission. So by doing a good product, so how can we do social mission? We need to give a good product to the society. So with the lesser cost. So that is a social mission. So today a car is actually, let us say there is 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs. If we could able to sell another car with the same quality with 4 lakhs or 3.5 lakhs, it is a social mission. Not on a car. Okay. It is a social mission. They are not going to get much of profit in that project. It is a social mission. The person or people who never thought of anything about to buy a car, they can buy a car. Okay. So like this, it is a social mission. So to do this, okay, what we can do? So first of all, we need to secure our profit. Okay. So any company to sustain that or to do social mission and all, so what is the basic requirement? The company should have profit. Okay. So how to increase or even sustain the profit or increase the profit? Please give feedback. Whatever you have in your mind, please tell. Okay. What are all the ways to increase profit in the workshop this year? So let us say my company's profit is 3 crores. So I want to make it as 5 crores. Next year I want to have 5 crores as a profit. So what I need to do or what we need to do?
Introduce new models.
Introduce new model which in turn will increase the number of quantity. Okay. Increasing the sales. Okay. Then new technology. Then
we need to update the
specification
of the same model. Okay.
So whatever we do, our competitors also will do the same thing. We have competitors. There may be 5-6 competitors. Okay. Whatever we do, they will also do.
But we are the first ones. But we are the first ones.
So that's why. So how to actually improve the profit? So what is the formula for profit?
Sir, marketing.
Okay, I will come. Okay, marketing. So if you do marketing, they will also do marketing. Okay, that's why. Okay, what is the formula for profit? Profit is equal to retail price minus cost. Or otherwise, actually, retail price equal to cost plus profit. Okay, there are, but it is having its own meaning. If I say our selling price is equal to cost plus profit, okay, so cost we cannot do anything, okay, so then we can add the profit to fix the selling cost. It is not a mathematical formula. If our selling price is equal to cost plus profit, then cost is fixed. We are going to fix our profit whatever we want. So we are, based on that, we are going to fix the retail price. But that formula will not work out right now. Clear? So nowadays, you are going to go to what are all the futures? Now actually the, all the customers are very well knowledge. They know actually the equivalent product, their equivalent product function. Okay. So they know everything. So they will compare the cost. Okay. So, so we cannot just like that add, yeah, I need 20% profit. We just add the cost with 20% profit, then we cannot fix the selling price. Now it is not the actually seller's market. You know about seller's market and buyer's market. Okay, it's not seller's choice. It's now actually buyer's choice. Okay, so the buyer only will fix the rate. I don't want this for 4 lakhs. I want it for only 3.5 lakhs. Then how to reduce 50,000? Okay, so that is the market now. So now profit is equal to retail price minus cost. Okay, the retail price we fixed by whom? Present, not the company, presently it is customer. If the buyer fix, sorry, company fix some cost actually, the customers will not buy it. Okay, so we need to only fix the viable cost, retail price. So this is been, the philosophy is this is being fixed by our customers or buyers, and the cost is whatever the cost we are able to manage. So retail price minus cost only the profit. Okay, if this is equal we will not get any profit, if this is more than this actually we will have loss. So if we want to secure profit we need to reduce cost. Okay, so that is what here says, if this is the retail price. Okay, so this is our cost and this is our profit, then this is the retail price. So the way to increase the profit is we can increase the retail price, so that also will give good profit, but whether it is possible. So if you increase the profit, nobody is going to buy the product. Okay, then other way is we can sell instead of 100, if is, we are able to sold 150 numbers, then we can have a more profit. But if whether we can able to increase our sales all of a sudden, that is not possible. Our customers also in the same manner, they also want to increase their sales. So that is not possible. Then we need to reduce this cost. If we are able to reduce this cost, our profit will be with the same retail price, our profit will increase. So that is the strategy. So that is where the Toyota production system, okay, so concentrates. So then how to reduce this cost, input cost. So that is what actually our Toyota production system says. So the ways to increase profit, raise retail prices, but our customers won't, our products won't sell if we increase the retail price. Boost sales, our competitors also make efforts to increase the sales volume and reduce cost. Yes, this is the solution, because profit may vary even if same number of products are sold for the same price. Are they same price? With the same price, with the same quantity, selling quantity, we can get more profit. The way is to reduce the cost. So other things are not in our hands, but reducing the cost is in our hands. So how to reduce the cost? So that is only we are going to see. So the component of cost is material cost, energy cost, labor cost, depreciation, maintenance, and there are so many other costs. Okay. So whether this is common for all the competitors, A, B, C, there are three competitors, whether this will be same for all the three or not. So material cost, so raw material cost will be same. Okay, per kg of ferrous, okay, is steel. If you buy it, it is 44 or 45 rupees. So this is going to be common for all the competitors. So then how to? So the energy cost for all the customers is going to be same. Labor cost may be little bit of difference, but mostly it will be same. Then depreciation will be same, maintenance cost also will be same, then other costs also almost same. Then how to reduce the cost? So how to reduce this cost is how we are going to manufacture it. That is only in our hand. Okay, by converting a raw material into a product is in our hand. Okay, so that is where the way we manufacture will differ a customer to customer. So if we have a good manufacturing system, so which can eliminate all kind of waste, then our cost will be less, so that our profit will be more. So that is the philosophy. Okay, next. So even using the same materials, the same amount of power, the same degree of payment, some companies gain profit but others do not. So why does this suppose this? Other is because of the manufacturing, the kind of manufacturing system we have. Okay. So this is our one competitor spends this much, the other competitor spends this much. So the material cost here, I saw it as less. So how will it be less? There are so many things. Let us say, the steel price may be same. You want to have a 10.4 diameter, a cylindrical, okay, a component. So how will you buy? What will be the raw material? Raw material size. What is the standard raw material size available? Say, so let us say there is 11 amount. Okay, then you need to turn it to 10.4. So there is a 0.6 amount is waste. Okay, so if we could buy it by at least by 10.5. Okay, since it requires for some surface finish, if we could able to buy it by 10.5 amount, there will be 0.5 amount of raw material will get saved. Okay, so if and another one thing is the surface finish. Let us say we need to have a dirty finish. Okay, but if we don't have a dirty machine, okay, we have only grinding machine. Okay, then if we grind it, our cost will be higher. So more than required also, sometimes we will talk about we will give better quality. Okay, so better quality or not, we don't know. Whether what is the required quantity, that we need to ensure. So that we should not actually over process. Okay, so if the material cost reduces, okay, the lead time or the number of operations is reduced, so our cost of material, that is the cost of component, will come down. If this component is coming down, energy also consumption will be little bit come down. Let us say for making a product, a big product, the turning, whatever the process, it is taking 2 hours. So if it reduces from, let us say, 11 ohm rod, for 100 numbers making, it is taking, let us say, 1 hour. So if we are pressing it from 11 ohm to 10.4, for 1 hour, it is taking 1 hour for 100 numbers. So how much time it will take for 10.5 to 10.4? Okay, at least there will be, let us say it is 40 minutes or 50 minutes. So there will be a 10 minutes saving. Okay, if 10 minutes say, our material cost will reduce, our energy cost also will be reduced. Okay, our labor cost also, instead of 1 hour, you can spend only 15 minutes. Okay, then our depreciation also will be reduced. The machine, let us say the machine will run for another 5 years. So then every hour there will be a depreciation cost. So instead of 1 hour depreciation cost, we will take only 15 minutes depreciation cost. So all other component costs are the derivative of the material or processing cost. Everything will come down. So this much cost will be reduced. So that is our profit. So if we strengthen our manufacturing system, the way how to manufacture, if we have a best system, our cost will come down, so that our profit will increase. Okay. So now let us enter into Toyota production system. It is called as TPS. Most of the person may not call it as Toyota production system. Do you know about TPS? Okay. So TPS or Toyota production system. Reducing cost through elimination of MUDA. That is what TPS, Toyota production system. Reducing cost through elimination of MUDA. So MUDA nu kelippittirukkeengla, you heard about the word MUDA. Okay, it is a Japanese word. MUDA is waste. Okay, so we need to eliminate, not only to reduce waste, it is actually we need to eliminate all kind of waste so that our waste will be reduced, so that our material cost will be less, cost will be less, our profit will be more. Okay, so to achieve it, இதை நம்ம அச்சீவ் பண்ணணும் அப்படின்னு சொன்னால் வாட் ஆர் ஆல் வி நீட்ஸ் டு டூ ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஒன்லி சேலபிள் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் இன் தி ரைட் குவான்டிட்டி அண்ட் ரைட் டைம் ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஒன்லி சேலபிள் ப்ராடக்ட் ஓகே இஃப் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு செல் இட் டுடே லெட் அஸ் சே Hyundai இஸ் செல்லிங் கார் எவ்ரி டே தே ஆர் கோயிங் டு செல் லெட் அஸ் சே 2000 கார் தென் வி நீட்ஸ் டு ப்ரொடியூஸ் ஆல்சோ ஒன்லி 2000 கார்ஸ் we should not produce one day more and one day less. If we produce more, our inventory, there will be an inventory. So already we have inventory piled up, so that much of money will be lost. Okay. So produce only saleable products with the right quality at right time. So make higher quality products, make more reasonable price products by elimination of moda, and create flexible and strong organized workforce. Okay. So these are all the four ways. So now I am going to tell you. So what are all these? Okay. Next. So we have talked about how to reduce Buddha, another waste. Okay. So you also please practice the word Buddha. See, if you say Buddha, so the whenever even if you got interviewed, they know that you know this system. Okay. So how do you mean Buddha? Okay. There are seven kind of ways of Buddha. So have you heard about? So I think if you are, please write down this thing. So it will be useful. After this, you please go to and search in net. So it will be useful for you. So don't think that it is different from your curriculum. Okay. So there are seven types of ways. So what are the seven types of ways? First of all, Muda is the element of production that does not add any value. So what is value addition and non-value addition? Anybody tell? In any process, what is value addition and what is the non-value addition? So let us say, in a turning process, machine is there. So I am the turner. I am just actually taking this product, clamping this product. Okay. Then I am doing turning. Then actually declamping this. Then I take the micrometer. I measure this. Then I am keeping here. Okay. In this, what is value addition? Value addition is only the turning time is the value addition. All the other things is not a value addition. Okay, time. So the customer will, whether the customer will pay, you are actually clamping it by manual or clamping it by using machine or some other clamping mechanism. So they will pay only for this turning operation. Okay, the others are actually not adding any value to the product. So that is what actually it is a value addition and a non-value addition. We should increase value addition and we should decrease non-value addition. Okay, so these are all the seven types of moda or waste. So let us actually start from here. One is overproduction. So we should not produce more. Okay, then next one is overprocessing. Okay, so what is the required size of quality level or what is the required level of processing? That only we need to do. We need not do any over processing and conveyance from actually from here to here. So from one one process to other process, there should not be much of distance. So the transportation time should be less. And another thing is inventory. You should not have more inventory. So when we want to produce, so if you are doing this operation, just if it is here, it is okay. So if you should not wait actually from yesterday or 10 days before itself, we buy it, that garment is lying here. Okay, so inventory. And another one is motion. So if I am here, I am doing this operation, everything should be in front of my reaching level. What is our reaching level? So this is our reaching level. This and this. From this circle, all the components should be available. Or otherwise our motion will be waste motion will be there. And also always we need to use both the hands. If you want to assemble something, so take it and again take this. Today both the hands. We need to pick. Always use both the hands. So that is actually motion. Then actually waiting time. So two persons are working. Okay. So one person is taking 20 minutes. So the next operation is taking only 60 minutes. Okay, he will complete it in 16 minutes. Then the next will piece will come only after another 4 minutes. Okay, so we need to wait for another 4 minutes. So that is waste. Okay, so the waiting time should not be there. There are so many times, techniques how to reduce this waiting time. Okay, next. So for this, you can, how you are going to remember in your mind?
waste, 7 type of waste. So there is a word to easily remember this, tin wood, T-I-M-W-O-O-D, tin wood. Okay, it is a person's name. So that is been actually used to remember it. Tin means, T means transportation. Okay, Kuda is transportation. I, inventory. M, motion. W, waste. O, over processing, over production. Okay, D for defect. So tin wood, these are all the 7 types of waste. So we need to reduce this waste. Okay. So now we are going to talk about this house of biota. So if you remember this, okay, you can able to explain the things whatever I explained so far or even afterwards. If you remember this, this one is enough. Okay. This is what all about biota production system or lean manufacturing. Okay. So for this house, okay, the base. So this is the foundation. Okay. The biota production system, the foundation is standardized work and Heijunga. So Heijunga also and Japanese word. So I will tell you what is Heijunga. Okay. The foundation is standardized work by Heijunga. Okay. Then the two pillars are, so without this pillars will not stand. Okay. After we put this foundation, there will be two pillars. One pillar is JIT. What is JIT? Just in time. Okay. I will explain what is just in time. Okay. One is the just in time and the other one is JIDOKA. What is JIDOKA? This is also a Japanese word. You please draw this house. Okay. Definitely it will be useful. Whether you are taking notes for other things or not, that is different, but you need to know the house of Toyota. Okay, so JIDOKA means it is called as automation with human mind, or otherwise it is called as autonomation. Okay, so what is automation with human mind? So if a machine is able to detect any defect, okay, so what normally we will do after completing this operation, we will inspect and so we will say whether it is okay or not. But the machine will not allow this. Machine will have a human mind. It will not allow the defects to happen till it is able, or otherwise it can able to detect the defect, or even it can prevent the some breakdowns. So like that, so what a human can do for that particular process, if that is being done by that machine itself, okay, so that is called as autonomation, or automation with human mind, or JIDOKA. Okay, so next, so in JIT, there is one thing is called as tag time production, okay, the next thing is continuous flow. Next, full production. Okay, so JIT, there is three tools. There are three tools. Okay, so how to do JIT? So we can have just in time production by implementing these techniques. Those three are tag time production, continuous flow, and full production. Okay, then this automation or JIDOKA, we have and. Okay, next one, Poke-Yoke. Have you heard about Poke-Yoke? Poke-Yoke. Mistake proofing. Have you heard about mistake proofing? No. Okay, Poke-Yoke or mistake proofing, that is actually means that will not, a process will not allow to produce a defect. Okay, that is called as, there are three types of Poke-Yoke. Either that prevent the mistake, or it will inspect the mistake. Okay, or otherwise the mistake, the product with the defect, so cannot go to the next workstation.